callers that were chosen to get this call?
It was of my volition.
Was the list intended to reach black voters?
I was never given any specific as far as ethnicity.
Were you given any specifics as to party? Call Republicans versus Democrats.
I got voters, Baltimore City, and Prince George's County. That's all I was told.
You had the opportunity, if you had taken a little more time, to get, as you put it, Republican voters, independent voters, that would have been a wider group. Am I correct?
Given the time that it came, it was crunch time, I made the decision to use lists that were already pre-uploaded that we used in the previous cycle.
Told us that you testified that Mr. Henson said that the call was intended to be counterintuitive. Could you just explain what you said on the witness stand?
You want me to go through my analogy of counterintuitivity. The call was literally meant to stimulate voters that would not have been in support of O'Malley or the Democratic administration, that this would stimulate the voters to say, hey, my vote was going for Ehrlich, he's down and out, I'm going to go out and vote for Ehrlich after I heard this call. So that's the motivation of counterintuitivity.
And did you ever have any conversations with Paul Scherer?
No, I've never spoken to Paul Scherer.
Knowing what you know now and what has happened now, would you have had a chance to do it all over again? Would you have done anything differently?
Would I have done anything differently? That's a good question, but I would have to weigh the circumstances that I had personally with regard to my decision.
Rhonda, you know this case, what this case is about.
Yes.
It's a case that alleges illegal voter suppression. What would you call it?
I would call it a political tactic of counterintuitive.
Does that mean reverse psychology?
Reverse psychology. That's what I used on the stand today, and that's what was the motivation by my boss, Julius Henson. That's what he told me, and that's what we're sticking to.
Why do you continue to work for Mr. Henson? I mean, if this his work led to you being here and led to this trial, why would you continue to work for him?
Mr. Henson is... was the person that had given me an opportunity in this neck of the woods, because my political career has been all over the country and not really at home.